Hello, it all started over 15 years ago when I read that you could drop kick a V cube 7 without it breaking. Since a V cube doesn't really bounce, I think they meant what Americans would call a punt. In 2008, I decided to try with a cube, which I was going to cut up for a project anyway. I was amazed that even when landing on concrete, it was largely undamaged. I then did keepy-uppies with the same cube. Several years later, when the first 17x17 came out, the manufacturers released this video testing a prototype for strength. Once again, amazingly, it survived. Knowing how strong it was, I decided to make a few daft videos where it appeared I was risking a very expensive puzzle. If my stunts went wrong, however, I knew the cube was unlikely to be damaged. So I stood on it, threw it in some water, and even juggled with two. Then I took things a little further and attempted to walk on a slack line holding a 17x17 and Eximinx, which I figured would be just as robust. I tried multiple times and this was my best attempt. Each time I failed, I was able to simply step off the line safely. That is, until the very last try when things went very wrong. I was initially winded and just kind of froze for a couple of seconds, thinking about whether I'd hurt myself or the puzzles. I was, however, fine, and the puzzles were too, with just one part of a corner coming unattached from the 17x17. Now, I did this on grass, so it would be safer for me and the puzzles, but looking at it in slow motion, it looks like the Eximinx may have hit the top of the metal gas container behind me, which I was using to tension the line. Or it could have hit my bottom, but I don't recall that. Either way, it was 100% fine, but I won't be trying this again.